Hello and welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. In this video, we're going to take on a very difficult topic. We're going to work on understanding implicit differentiation. Now, if you've seen this before, you know that it can be a very tricky process, but I'll give you a really big hint on how this is going to play out. It's all about the chain rule, okay? So we're going to do some simple problems involving the chain rule just to get our minds going on how the chain rule works so that we can really understand that implicit differentiation part, okay? So here's the idea. When we have a function inside of another function, let's say I have my g function inside of f, then we want to take the derivative of the outside. So in this case, I'm going to work on that square root guy, working on taking its derivative. So let's see, 1/2, we'll reduce the power by 1, negative 1/2. So I've taken the derivative of the outside. Now we're going to leave that inside function just as it is, and then multiply by the derivative of the inside. Okay, so again, in taking the derivative of our composition of functions, we have the derivative of the outside, inside stays the same, multiplied by the derivative of the inside. Now, it doesn't really matter what that inside function is. In fact, it could be a completely different function, like sine of x, and that same process is going to play out. So let's do this problem again. Now our inside function is going to be sine of x. All right, so just like last time, we will do the derivative of our outside function. So I took down the power, reduced it by 1. Inside function will stay the same, then we'll multiply by the derivative of the inside. So in this case, the derivative of sine is cosine. All right, now again, I'm going to emphasize that it doesn't matter what that inside function is. In fact, it could be any general function. Let's suppose it was just a g of x. The process is not going to be any different. We'd start off with the derivative of the outside. So there, I've reduced the power. Inside is going to stay exactly the same. And now I will multiply by the derivative of the inside. Now, if you followed all three of those examples, you can do implicit differentiation. What often messes people up with implicit differentiation is that it's a common practice to write that inside function y of x as simply just a y. But really, there's no difference in writing it as y of x or writing it just as y. So let's do a couple more chain rule problems and kind of practice with this notation. So here I have my f function and y is on the inside, y of x. So if I'm taking the derivative of this guy, I'd start with the derivative of the outside. Cosine is the derivative of sine. Our inside function is just going to stay exactly the same, y of x. Then we'll multiply by the derivative of the inside. So this is what the chain rule looks like when you're using that function notation. Now, since it's common practice to simply write y and assume that it is a function of x, here's how that same problem looks using the more common notation. So I'm trying to take the derivative of f, and I start off taking the derivative of sine. So there's my cosine. The inside's going to stay exactly the same, so we're just going to write a y multiplied by the derivative of the inside, y prime. So that's implicit differentiation. I'm taking the derivative of my function. Since I don't know y exactly, it has to stay the same, and its derivative, I'm just going to express that as a y prime. So now, we're actually ready to do some implicit differentiation problems. And watch how that common notation, this y and the y primes, keep showing up every time I take the derivative. So in this one, I want to find the derivative of y with respect to x, and we're going to assume that y is a function of x. So I'm going to start off by actually just taking the derivative of both sides. And I'm using this notation to say, okay, I'm going to take the derivative, and then we'll go ahead and do that in the next step. Now, over here on the left, it's that chain rule guy that's going to play a part. So we'll do the derivative of the outside. You know, I've brought down the power, reduced it by 1, so this is to the power of 1, so I'm not going to write it. Inside will stay exactly the same, and then I'll multiply by the derivative of the inside. So there's all that chain rule stuff playing out. Now on the right side, the derivative of x with respect to x is simply just 1, so you'll do those derivatives like you normally would. There's just a few more steps. Usually we want to isolate that derivative of y. So I'm going to divide both sides by 2y. And now I'm done. So y prime is equal to 1 all over 2y. Let's give this another a shot at something a little bit more complicated. So again, we want to find the derivative of y with respect to x. And we can see that we have a couple of y's hidden in there. And we also have some x's. So when we do the derivative on those, it'll be exactly like a normal derivative. Think that we're using the chain rule really to take care of these guys. All right, let's start off. So I'm going to start off with the derivative of sine of y. The derivative is cosine. Inside will stay exactly the same, multiplied by the derivative of the inside, y prime. Plus, now we're taking the derivative of 3x squared, 6x. And I'm going to use the chain rule again to help me with this guy. So the derivative of the outside, I'd bring down the 3, reduce it by a power of 1. Now I'm multiplying by the derivative of the inside, y prime. Okay, off to the other side of the equal sign, derivative of 4 is simply 0. So I've been able to take the derivative. I now have these derivative of y pieces in here, and we want to collect them together and isolate them. So cosine of y, y prime, minus 3y squared, y prime. The 6x, let's go ahead and put that on the other side. So minus 6x. We have two of them, so we're going to factor those out front. So y prime multiplied by cosine of y minus 3y squared. All right, it's looking pretty good. We have our y primes together. Now we'll just divide by all of this, and it will be completely isolated. So y prime is equal to a negative 6x all over cosine of y minus 3y squared. So when it all boils down to what you're doing with implicit differentiation, you're still finding the derivative of y with respect to x, but what you see in the derivative is often you need to know lots of information about that function. For example, you need to know information about x's and y values. Whereas when you're doing just a normal derivative, a function with just x's in it, then all you need to know is their x values. So go ahead and talk about that derivative. All right, so remember that the implicit differentiation is all about thinking about the chain rule, and you'll do just fine. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit mysecretmathtutor.com.